Do you have any incurable or contagious diseases?
No.
Are you homosexual?
Of course not.
Do you intend to assassinate the President of the United States?
This is ridiculous.
Are you refusing to answer the question?
That's not the point. Do you think if anyone was going to try and kill your president, they would admit it?
I don't write these questions, I just ask them.
I find your insinuations extremely insulting.
I'm sorry. There is no way, however, that I can allow you to live in the United States.
Listen, I'm a businessman. I've already made arrangements.
The interview's over. I have a very important meeting.
This is very important. There must be a way. I'm prepared to give you any amount.
Well, you are indeed a businessman, aren't you? Therefore, you understand the importance of good faith and trust. Let me explain something to you. I've been entrusted by the government of the United States of America with a very important job, and I won't betray it. You get out before I have you arrested.
Frank March thinks he's better than everyone else. His rigid posture and proper posturing is meant as an example to the world around him. But a lot of the time, those people who are most critical are also the ones with the most to hide.
You don't mind the room?
Not at all.
Look what I bought you today.
It's something special.
Something just for you. Because you deserve it, Frank. You're an important man. A diplomat. You deserve to be happy. You work so hard.
No!
What's wrong?
It's not the line. Special men deserve special pleasures. Start over again.
Only if you give me more money.
You're not getting anything if you don't do it right.
I hate creeps like you.
Ah, picky whore, huh?
Where do you think you're going? Where's my money? Marco! Marco!
Shut up! There's your money, okay? Can you hurry up, please? We don't have much time.
Will you zip me up, please?
I told you not to wear that dress.
Frank, I'm sorry, but I'm really not sure I feel like going out after all. I've changed my mind.
What do you do this to me for, Catherine? I mean, you know how important tonight is. I just don't understand you sometimes, Catherine. Like now. Go change your dress.
Why?
It's totally inappropriate, that's why.
No, it is not. It's my new dress, and I look wonderful in it.
You look like a whore.
And just what would you know about whores, Mr. Expert?
Look, it's an important embassy function, all right?
It's a simple black dress, Frank, not the Soviet flag.
Look, Catherine, we have a responsibility as part of the diplomatic corps.
Diplomatic corps? You? You're just an embassy employee.
That's all I'm ever going to be with the help I get from you. Try the red one. Catherine, do you think you can behave yourself tonight?
Don't worry. I'll just find some quiet little corner to smoke my opium.
I'm not kidding.
You're looking very handsome, Ray.
Why, thank you, Catherine. Nice to see you.
Andy?
Oh, Frank, while I've got you here, I just wanted to talk to you real briefly about your speech to the ambassador tonight, okay?
Well, I know it's real important, Ray. I've worked hard on it.
Yeah.
Who's that man talking to, Catherine?
Oh, that's Peter Yale.
What's he do?
Oh, a few odds and ends for us. Nothing official. Now, the way I see it, Frank, it's more of a toast, really. You know, something short and sweet, nothing too serious. Right, Frank? Is anything wrong?
Everything's fine. Thanks. I got a phone call, Ray.
Oh, certainly. Don't be too long. We gotta get started.
This?
You're so important. Such a big man. A diplomat. You deserve to be happy.
What do you want?
I want you to answer the phone, Frank.
What are you talking about? Hello.
What have you been doing, Frank? Just wait until everyone finds out.
Finds out what?
What you've been hiding. Have you found it yet, Frank?
I don't think you know who you're dealing with.
It's right there, very close. You better find it before someone else does.
Mr. Ambassador.
So, Mr. Ambassador has returned. Oh, don't you have any other color for a change?
How much?
How much?
Yeah.
$2,000, counting what you cheated me last time.
Don't play with me. I want to know how much.
Okay, you want to know how much?
Yeah.
$10,000.
How much?
You think I'm too cheap?
How much?
$100,000.
$100,000. Do you have more of these?
Enough.
I don't have that kind of money.
I have a lot more pictures where that came from. I'd love to see the look on your ambassador's face when he gets them.
Next week.
Mm-mm. tonight.
It's impossible.
What will your wife say, huh?
Just passing by. Got a few minutes?
Actually, I'm kind of busy right now, Ray.
I thought that maybe we should talk.
Oh, about last night. What, I told you. I'm sorry about that, Ray. You know, I don't know what happened. I got kind of sick, okay?
So you said. And it doesn't matter anyways. Last night's not important. I'm a little concerned that something's wrong. Are you having any kind of problem? Maybe at home.
Problems? Me? What makes you think that, Ray?
Nothing. But if you ever need to talk, I hope you know you can come to me. Okay?
Yeah, sure.
Don't forget.
No, it's important that you do this exactly how I told you. Yeah, don't be late either. I have to go.
Who are you talking to?
Nobody.
What's wrong, Frank?
Nothing.
Don't lie to me. Ray called this afternoon.
Well, what did he want?
He's worried about you. He asked me some strange questions about you, about us.
Well, I really don't want to talk about it right now.
Look, I've never seen you like this before. What's the matter?
Nothing's the matter, except that everybody keeps grilling me. I'm fine. Everything's perfectly normal.
You'll never admit, will you, that your life's anything other than what you think it should be?
But you looked so earnest.
Get the hell out of here.
Thank you.
Yes.
You must be plenty scared to come back the same day, huh? Let's see it. Not here. Come on.
The negatives.
Show me the money. Let me count it. I'll go get the negatives. Stay here.
I'll keep the money.
Don't you trust me?
No.
If that bag moves an inch, you can kiss your pictures goodbye.
Is this what you're looking for?
Ray.
I would never have believed it of you, Frank.
You don't understand.
You're right. I don't.
Look, it's just a mistake, okay?
Your meeting last night under the bridge was a mistake. What were you doing there?
My job. I mean, I decide who gets visas and who doesn't. Isn't that right? This man, he came in, he said, hey, I need a visa. I said, no, you can't have one. And then I thought about it. That's all, Ray. I just thought about it, and then I changed my mind. Big deal.
You're accepting 100,000 francs as part of your job?
I don't know what you're talking about.
I have the man's statement.
What man? What are you doing to me, Ray? I thought that you knew me.
How many times have you accepted money in exchange for immigration visas?
Never.
Explain this.
How did you get that, Ray? I wasn't there. What do you have, guys, sitting upstairs making pictures up? I wasn't even there. You're trying to frame me.
Read him his rights.
So?
I had really hoped up to the last.
Of course, Ray. There was nothing you could do.
I suppose you're right. But I don't relish having to tell his wife.
Why don't you let me do it?
Thanks. And Peter, thanks. Yes. You did a good job, especially at such short notice.
Don't mention it.
Frank March has no idea what happened. Like most hypocrites, he didn't understand that when he created one set of rules for himself and another for the people around him, all he was doing was setting a trap for himself.